a spot that's pretty good there.
Babe, don't make a sound.
Take a huge inhale, forward fold, exhale. And I'm gonna move this just a little so you can see her feet. Stay in your forward fold for just a second, just because it's a little earlier today. Let that spine really open, stay in your ragdoll. Maybe you can kind of move your knees right and left, right and left. We're gonna start with kind of a heat builder. You can either stay in your forward fold, I'm just chatting. You can either hold on to weights for this next little set, or you do not have to use them. It's your choice. Maybe you start with the weights, you're like, yeah, it's not working for me. Roll up one vertebrae at a time. Grab the weights if you choose. If not, it's no big deal. All we're doing is we're taking a lunge back, so make sure you have enough space. It's a lunge back, and then it's a hinge, touch the floor, stack, lunge in. Okay, nice and slow. We're gonna do five on the right, five on the left, five on the right, five on the left. There you go. Make sure you don't fall behind you there. Open up the chest. With weights in your hands or without, I'm not using them. My model on the right. You know how the real professional ladies have like three? For the beginners, go with Susie. For the advanced, go with Sydney. With the having fun, go with Monica. Here we go. Right foot goes back first. Ready? Step into a perfect lunge with the chest open. Then drop the knee, touch the floor. Bring it up, step together. Let's try it again, ready? Chest stay super open, hands at your side. Step back, drop forward, touch the floor or close to it. Stack, bring it in, that's two. Take it back, lean forward, touch. You kind of drop that knee just a little bit to get to the floor. Stack. Bring it in, that's three. Let's do it again. Back, chest open. Hinge, touch the floor. Back, step it in, that's three. I know it's four, but I'm just saying three. Here we go. Hinge, touch, stack. Bring it in, oh, that's hard. Let's do it again, this is number five. Step, hinge, stack. Now stay here, stay here. So if you came back up to standing, go back to your lunge. Your shoulders are over your hips. You come down just another inch, and then it's five little presses up, those traditionals. It's just one, two, three, four, five. Hold it on the down. Everybody come down just another inch. Come down just another inch. Take your shoulders, send them back. Just kind of open through the chest and come down one more inch. Hang out here for three, for two, for one, and step together. Let's go to the other side. Ready? Here we go. Keep the chest open. Left leg. If you use the left leg first, that's okay. Just go to the other side. Chest is open. Here comes that left leg. You step. Chest stays open. We'll go slow for the first two. You hinge, drop the knee, take your fingertips to the floor. Stack. Come together. Step back. Hold. Hinge, drop the knee, drop the hands. Back. Perfect. That's two. Send it back. Drop hinge. That's three. remember that I did one extra. Send it back. Keep everything open. Now hinge, touch the floor, drop the knee. This is three. Here we go, number four. Hinge, touch. Bring it together. So everybody should be a little warmer. Last one. Hinge, touch. Perfect. And bring it in. Open up through your chest. If you did use your weights for this, hold on to them. If you didn't use them, grab them. We're gonna do one quick set of arms. Oh, the bounce. Thank you, Model Sydney, remembered. Ready? Take your left leg, send it back. No hinge here, no hinge here. Open up through your chest, sink your hips, and then it's those five little presses and a bunch of holds. Here we go. Thank goodness I have a model. It's one, and she was my technical assistant too. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Hold it on the 10. Hold it on the 10. Hold it down just another inch for three, two, one, and now release. Beautiful. Here we go. So this song is not a song that I traditionally play in class, but I love it, so we're going to use it. Ready? Arm, I'm going to have the song on. It's super basic. It's just up and downs, in and out, bicep curls. So just follow me. Here we go. Let me put it just. I'll stay. Yeah.
I'm not a stranger to the dark. Hide away, they say, because we don't want your broken parts. I've learned to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, you say,
in and out.
I'll love you as you are, but I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us, for we are glorious.
Ready?
When the sharpest words want to cut me down.
Your fingertips to face the sky. So I'll put the song back on. The first few is going to be with the fingertips towards the sky, and then we're going to rotate it with the palm towards the sky. So fingertips and then palms. Ready? Here we go. It went all the way to the beginning. How do I go back to where I was? Thank you. Ready? Here we go. Hold. Hold. Soft bend reach. Wait for it. Awesome. Here we go. Ready? That was not arm work, friends. That was just a little tiny bit of, what do you call that? Warm up. Ready? Go ahead and drop your weights. Take one huge breath in. Let's get down on the floor for abs. Forward fold. Take your hands to the top of your mat. Walk or jump back into your first plank of the day. So remember that little leg piece in the beginning that wasn't leg. And remember that the arm that we just did with that song was just because I like the song. It was not arm work. It was just, I love that song, This Is Me, from, what's the name of the Greatest Showman.
We're in a plank.
Oh, we're in a plank, she said. I forgot. The model is telling me that we're in a plank. Lengthen out through your head. Inhale. Huge exhale. One more big inhale. Really pull the abdominal in here. Huge exhale. Now come on to all fours. Bring your knees underneath your hips. So you're literally on all fours. You're going to take, now I want you in profile, because now we actually have more space. We moved the camera today. So now we're in profile. Sydney's in profile, so you can see her. Take a glance if you need to look. You're going to send your spine to the sky for cat, chin towards your chest. And then you send the belly to the floor, your gaze to the sky for your cow, and then come into a neutral spine. Curl the toes under, just curl the toes under. Now with all the might in your abdominal, lift your knees up off the floor, just maybe an inch or two for that neutral spine plank. Just hold the neutral spine plank. Now we're gonna go for a little walk and just do your best. You're gonna lift your knees up off the floor, they're just lifted for that neutral spine plank. You're pulling the abdominal so tight you can't even stand it. All you're going to do is you're gonna send your right foot, send it back, bring it in, hold the neutral spine plank. Right foot, send it, right. Stay right, stay right. So we're gonna go five right, five left. That makes it a little bit easier. So let's start again. Neutral spine plank, your knees are lifted. Right foot five times, send the right back, bring it in. 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 Last one, send the right back, bring it in and hold the plank, pull the abdominal. Set the knees to the floor, send your spine for your cat, and one quick cow. I see somebody in a full plank, that's fantastic. Bring the knees underneath your hips, and then let's go for the left side. So now we're in that just basic, right? Hands and knees, pull the abdominal, and lift the knees up off the floor. Left side, just five. Send the left foot back, and bring it in. Send the left foot back. That's exactly it. Bring it in. Send it back for three. Bring it in. Send it back for four. Bring it in. Send it back for five. Hold the plank. Hold the neutral spine plank. Hang here for three. Hang here for two. Pull the abdominal. Pull the abdominal. Find the tightness. Drop the knees to the floor. Send your body back. Open up the knees into a child's pose. And the only reason I'm being nice is because it's stressful times, ladies, just because it's stressful times. Otherwise, you would not get the child's pose. You know that. I am not getting soft. I'm just taking a deep inhale and exhale with all of you. Come out of that quick little child's pose. Send your feet to the front. Grab a throw pillow. Grab a teddy bear. Grab a ball. We're going into abdominals, starting with high C curve. So I have Sydney in profile so you can see. The little throw pillow she's putting in her low back for high C curve. So she's in low C curve. Model doesn't know what we're doing. That's okay. Here we are. We're going to take our feet. Let's start with hip distance width apart with the feet. So the feet are hip distance width apart. The knees are hip distance width apart. Your hands are soft behind that thigh. Soft behind the thigh. That's not soft. And then the chest is open and the chin is away from your chest. here is the key. All of us know, right? For high C curve, it's that tuck. And the tendency with the tuck, let me see if you can see me, is to bring the shoulders forward when we tuck. Keep the shoulders open and then kind of soften yourself back just to the point that you find that catch in the abdominals. So here we are, find the catch. And then we put on a little bit of music because it's gonna be that just little tiny up and down and up and down. Here we go, take a deep inhale, huge exhale, and let's do it. Ready?
Are you drunk or not? Now judge what I'm doing. Are you high enough?
Up, back.
To excuse up, that I'm rolling. Up, cause I'm rolling. Is it late enough for you to come and stay over? Cause you're free to love. So tease.
You want to release your hands? Release your hands. Here we go.
I made no promises. I can't do golden rings, but I can give you everything. Magic is in the air. There ain't no science here, so don't get your everything. I made no promises. I can't do golden rings, but I can give you everything. Magic is in the air. There ain't no science here, so don't get your everything.
Here we go. Hold it here. Hold it here. Now, take a second if you need to come out of that high C curve. Otherwise, stay exactly where you are. Now, bring the knees together and bring the feet together. Walk the knees in. Walk the feet in. Make that one leg. So, the song is actually 1 minute more, and you can hear the beat for 30 seconds, and it shifts for 30 seconds. Maybe that shift in music is when you release your hands. If not, hold on the whole entire time. Keeping the chest open, keeping the chin away from your chest. Here we go. Here is that first 30 seconds.
And
hold. This is your final hold. You choose. Do you want to have your hands together or behind your thighs? Do you want to release your hands? It's just my count of five. I want everybody squeezing the thighs in super tight. Super, super crazy tight. Squeeze your thighs. Take your chin away from your chest. Find that curvature and hold here for three, for two, for one. Bring yourself up. If you had something behind your back, go ahead and sit yourself up. If you had something behind your back, go ahead and release that and drop your body all the way down to the floor, all the way down to the floor. Take your hands behind your neck, head, and shoulder, and then bring your feet a little closer in. So we're gonna do something a little different than low C curve. We're getting to low C curve, but a little different. Hands is behind your neck, head, and shoulder. Your right knee is gonna come in towards your chest. It's gonna be a single leg bicycle. It's no secrets. Keeping it very straightforward so we can do exactly what we need to do. Your head is gonna drop just a little when the leg extends. So let's curl in, lengthen the leg, drop the head a little. Yep, that's it, right leg only. Let's bring it in. Bring it in, send it back. Yeah, bring it in. It's actually send it long, right? So bring it in, send it out. Two. I know it's not two. Three. Now, here's the trick, ladies. the chin wants to come in towards your chest. Don't let it. Keep your chin away from your chest. So look up at the sky. If there's some webs that you haven't gotten to yet, that's okay. Get to the webs later. Don't worry about it. Just keep the chin away from your chest. Look up at the sky. I'm not sure where we're at. That figures. Three more. Just three more. Two and one. Now, keep that right knee in. If your left knee isn't, that's okay. Right knee is in. Drop the neck, head, and shoulder. Take your hands into surrenders. So keep the right knee in. Yeah. We're going to do 20 little hip lifts. And then we're going to lengthen out the leg for 20 more. So we're going to keep that seat work pretty straightforward. Ready? And we won't do Mary J today. Let's do it. I have the song. Ready? Here we go. Lift your hips ever so slightly. The knee is bent, but the foot is definitely higher than the knee. The foot is higher than the knee just slightly. Let's do it. 20 here. You know it's gonna, I'm gonna lose count. 1, 2, 3. Model says 14, I say 7. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold here, hold here, everybody hold. So that was 20-ish. Now, if you can, lengthen out that same leg. Make it longer. So it can either be up towards the sky or it could be just a little further down, whichever feels comfortable to you. When I lengthen my leg, it kind of gets into my hip flexor. I definitely need a little bend. So let's go 20 here. Don't drop that leg. Don't do it. Yeah, I saw that. Okay, here we go. Ready? Let's do it. 20 here. Lift, lift. Now the leg is a little longer. You got it. See, that's what happens with the music. Oh, and by the way, since all of you are on your backs, I went for coffee. That's why I lost track. Inhale. Exhale. Make that left hamstring really uncomfortable. Drop your hips to the floor. Beautiful work, you guys. Both feet are together. Hands behind the neck, head, and shoulder. Left knee comes in. Let's do those bicycles. It's going to be left side only for 10. Ready? We're going to bring everything in tight. Drop the head just a little, lengthen the leg. Bring everything in tight, lengthen. Beautiful. That's three and lengthen. That's four, lengthen. Five, lengthen. Six, seven, eight, nine. Last one. And 10. Drop the neck, head, and shoulder. Look what happens. The knee's already in place. This is so fantastic. What I want you to do before we get started on those little hip lifts, I want you to take your hands to your shoulder blades and just open up your chest, even on the floor. So it's literally, I'm not doing anything. I'm just giving you a little bit like of a chest opener. Just take your hands as a reminder to keep the chest open, even laying down. You can feel that chest open. That left knee is in. Here we go. You know it's 20 little hip lifts on the right-hand side is the one that's working, the left knee is in. It's more than 20. Don't get discouraged. Here we go. Thank you. three, two, one, and hold. Now you have that choice. Lengthen out the leg. Lengthen out the leg. If you put the tightness in your knee, make sure that you're squeezing through the quadricep. You're not hyperextending the knee. Here we go. It's 20 here. Ready? Let's finish this little seat work. Let's do it. Let it be uncomfortable. Let it be uncomfortable. We're going to do one more thing for our hip and seat-ish area before we get up to do thigh and arm work. Hold here for three, hold here for two, and then drop your hips. Now, I want you, it doesn't matter which way you look at me, I want you on one of your hips. So come on to your side. Now, I'm going to use the girl here as the model. Make sure that you can see me. Because you guys can see me, it cuts off, so I can't see a lot of you. So just make sure that you hear the cue. The shoulder has to be in alignment with the hip, and the hip has to kind of stay even. Don't let that hip open towards the sky or come forward towards the floor. So make sure that that alignment is there, okay? All you're going to do, the bottom knee can be soft. It doesn't matter what happens to the bottom knee. You're gonna take that top leg, whichever one you happen to be on, and lengthen it. So lengthen that top leg. Yeah, make it absolutely beautiful. Now, my friends, do not cheat because I'm not there. I want the leg as high as it will go, and I want you on your elbow and not on your hands like a sexy pose. I want you on your elbows because it actually gives that little area, the muffin top area, a little bit more of a different angle. So get the leg a little higher. Get the leg a little longer, little higher. Don't even move yet. Don't even move. Just a little longer and a little higher. The knee is the key here. It's not hyperextended. It's long. The quadricep is tight, but the knee is not hyperextended. Now, here we go. Tiny little lifts. It's 10 here. One, two. Don't kick. We're not in the can-can. We're not doing a show. We're lengthening, strengthening the hip. That's exactly where it should feel uncomfortable. It's how many? Five. The model doesn't know. Four. Three, two, hold it on the one. Hold it on the one. Now listen, don't drop the leg. Don't drop the leg. Lengthen it. Tighten the quadricep, but lengthen the knee, if that makes sense. Hang out here for three. Hang out here for two. Now you're going to take that leg that's in the air. You're going to bring it forward of you. It doesn't necessarily have to be a letter L. It could be kind of a V-ish shape. If you can get into the L, that's fantastic. Your toes on the floor. And here we are. Lift that leg, lift the leg. Now it's in front of you, right? It's no longer in alignment with your body. It's slightly in front of you. Just hold it, don't even move, don't even move, hold. Find the like little uncomfortableness in your hips. Let's lift here, tiny for 10, tiny. It's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, is the leg dropping? 10, hold it. Hold the 10, hold the 10. Lengthen the leg. I can see some faces. I like the little looking things. Hang for three, maybe a little higher there, model. Maybe for three, maybe a little higher for two.
My hip is cramping.
Yeah, her hip is cramping, so she's doing it right. For two, for one. Now you're gonna get that beautiful leg that's long and hopefully the hip is kind of hot and you're gonna bring it behind you. So now it's opposite, right? We had it along with our body. We had it in front of us. Now it's behind us. Ready? Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Hold it on the 10. Hold it on the 10. Get that leg longer. Get the leg longer. Maybe you remember that I can walk by you and just push it back an inch. Just an inch, and then maybe just an inch higher. Hang out. Hang for three, for two. Now look what happens. You're really close to a plank. I want you on your forearms. For one, drop that leg, whichever one you started with, roll yourself to face the floor. Your forearms are on the floor. Go into your first forearm plank of the day. We did a long arm plank. We did neutral spine. Here is your forearm plank. Tuck your hips, my friends. Tuck your hips. Don't be shy. You're at home. Tuck those hips. Tuck them hard. Now, if you're on your knees, stay on your knees. If you're not on your knees, I want just you to drop your knees to the floor. Tuck your hips really hard and then re-extend those knees. Keep that tight. Keep that tight. Just here for five. For four, really visualize the abdominal doing all of the work. Soften through the shoulders, soften through your arms. Tap your knees to the floor, and then let's go to the other leg. So turn around so you can see the screen if you choose. No big deal if you don't want to, because you know where we're going. You're on your elbow, not into the sexy pose. Your shoulder and hips and leg, they're gonna be aligned. They're gonna be aligned. Get that hip, touch that hip and align it. Make sure that you take a ruler, anything you have to make sure that everything is aligned. Lift that, do not put the leg on the sofa. The model is cheating, people. Lengthen out the leg, lengthen it out a little bit longer. And here we go, 10 little lifts. No, don't lift yet. Don't lift yet because everybody wants to lift to get it over with. Don't lift yet. Lengthen, 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 contract. Maybe it goes up another inch. Now let's go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Hold it on the 10. Hold it on the 10. Get the leg longer. Get the leg longer. Get the leg higher. Tighten that quadricep. You're going to take that beautiful leg and you're going to bring it forward of you. Tap it out to the floor. Put it on the floor. Put that toe on the floor. Take an inhale. Lift the leg back up. Lift the leg back up. Maybe it comes forward just a little bit more and maybe it goes up just a little bit higher. Yeah, so find that position that's uncomfortable and go forward just a little bit more uncomfortable and go up just a little bit more uncomfortable. Now let's do the 10. It's one, two, three, four, five. Do you guys see that? Sleepy model. I had to drag her out of bed. No, not 8:15. Why did you say 8:15? Five, six, seven. My next week, she's leaving. Next week, my son is the model. That's going to be a hoot and a holler. Three, two, hold it on the one. Now, here when you hold it on the one, lengthen out the leg. In my personal opinion, when I do this, well, I really don't because it's really hard. I just do it like two to make sure that it is hard and then I stop. But the front is a little bit harder than any of the other, the lengthen or the back. Lengthen the leg. Bring it just a little bit more forward and lift it up just a little higher, making sure that the shoulders and the hips stay aligned. Take that leg, send it behind you. Now, don't compromise the shoulders and the hips, right? Because the easier thing to do is when the leg goes back, the shoulder drops forward. Let's do it. Send the leg back, 10 little lifts. One, two, three, four, five. The easiest thing is to lean that whole body forward to get that leg farther back. Don't do it. I'd rather the leg not be that far back, but you perfectly align. Five, four, three, two. Find your final hold. Find your final hold. Lengthen out that leg. Visualize the ballerina leg. It's so beautiful. Think about how that lengthened of their legs. Find that same lengthening here. For three, here comes your final plank. Two, one, and release. Roll yourself over, go into your final forearm plank of the day. Final forearm plank of the day. Here we are. Tuck your hips. That's the critical piece. Critical piece is the tucking of the hips. Inhale. Soften through the shoulder. Exhale. Pull the abdominal in so tight that you can't stand it. Breathe. Yeah, that's a good one. Take a deep breath in. Pull the abdominal tighter. A huge exhale to soften through the shoulders for four, three, two, one, and release. Go ahead and curl your toes under, take your hands underneath your shoulders, pike into your downward dog. We're bringing ourselves up. What? Oh, it's 9:15. I thought like, what? I only have 10 minutes left. That's absurd. Curl the toes under, pike into your downward dog. Take a breath into your dog. Inhale, a huge exhale. Walk your hands in towards your feet in towards your hands. Roll up one vertebrae at a time. And now grab your chair Or if you're close to a wall, grab that. Let's see.
We'll move my camera over just a little bit so that it's a little bit more.
Okay. All right. Ready? Let's start with athletic feet. Heels together, toes apart. Heels together, toes apart. Now remember on Wednesday, I mentioned they can't see her feet, but that's okay. I can still cue it. Make sure that the heels are together, that the toes are apart, and the fist is what fits between the toes. A lot of times the toes will splay out a little bit too much. I want you to bring the toes a little bit in. So just visualize a fist between the, like your bunions. So make sure that just a fist fits there. Lift your heels up just a little bit. Those are kitten heels. Keep the heels together. So in athletic V, it's literally kitten heels. When we go into parallel, then it's the high heels. Kitten heels, soften the knees and come on down. Now don't lean forward. Make sure you're not leaning forward. And now it's just gonna be down and up, just tiny, tiny little presses. Ready? It's not presses, it's more of a down and an up, a down and an up. Here we go. Take it down. Little. Down. It's just. It's gonna be down for two, up for two. Ready? Here we go.
So you're a tough guy, like you really rough guy. Just can't get enough guy, just always the rough guy. I'm that bad type, make your mom sad type. Make your girlfriend mad type, might seduce your dad type. I'm a
hold! Little pulses! To 1-1. It's down and up, down and up, down and up. You got it. Keep going.
Likes to sing along with me, but she won't sing this song if she reads.
Two count. Ready? Down, down, up, up, down, down. Hold, hold. Little pulses to finish. Everybody hold. Squeeze your heels. Come down just a little bit lower. Squeeze your heels. Come down just a little bit lower. Hang out here for three, for two, for one, and release. Now bring the toes together, but have a little bit of distance between them. So we're going to go into lunge. So it doesn't matter. I'm just going to cue the leg that you have your hand on the chair, and then we're going to flip. So we're going to go back together. Legs up, and then it's a hold. So it's going to be lunge back, bring it together, and then find that long single leg lift. Drop, it's like the toe to the floor. Let's do it. Ready? So here we are. We're going to take the right leg, doesn't matter, right or left leg, whichever one you want to start with. You have a softness in your hands just to keep that balance. If you could do it without the wall, that's okay too. Let's do it. Right leg, left leg, doesn't matter. Send it back, hold. Bring it together. Find your stance. Lift that single leg. Hold the single leg. Let's do five little lifts here. One, two, three, four, five. tap the toe, send it back for lunge, hold the lunge, bring it in. My husband is taking pictures, seriously?
Oh my God, Dad.
Leg lengthens. You're changing the vibe. Five little lifts. One, two, you have got to be kidding. Three, four, five, and hold.
Dad.
Back. Okay, this is not professional. Out of the studio, ma'am. Please. Sorry, ladies. Sorry. What is he looking at taking pictures? Hold. Bring it in. Send the leg long. This is number three. One, two, three, four, five, and hold. Tap the toe together. Send the leg back. Hold that beautiful lunge. Ready? Together. Single leg lift. Hold it here. Five little lifts. One, two, three, four, five, and hold. For you ladies who have taken my class, the man is still alive. Bring it toe together, send it back. Ready? Hold it here, just hold it, just hold it. That left leg should be fatigued because it's kind of hoisting you back and forth. Bring it in, send the leg long. Five little lifts, one, two, three, four, five, and hold it there, lengthen the leg, lengthen the leg. Can you get that leg just a little longer? The fatigue should be on the left, but the engagement on the right. Hold for three, two, send the leg back. Here is your final lunge. Bring your hands into prayer. Ready? Up, down for 10. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Hold it on the 10. Hinge your body into that left leg. I promise this is 10 little presses to finish. One, two, just up, just up. Three, that left leg should be on fire.
Five,
six, seven, eight, nine. Hold it on the 10. Hold it on the 10. Can you bring the heel of that back foot, the foot that's in the back, just the heel comes in towards your butt a little bit. It changes the engagement. Lean forward just ever so slightly into that left leg. Hang. Now, this is what's really cool. Think about the heels of your hands. Press them together super tight. Press them together super, super, super tight and see how that engages the leg a little deeper. For three. Now, this is super fun. Take your hands to the floor. Send your leg back. You're in a plank. Just a transition. Just a transition. It's not a long plank. Inhale. Exhale, pike into your downward dog. Beautiful. Walk your hands in towards your feet. Oh, I see a kitty. Walk your hands to your feet to a hands. Roll up one vertebrae at a time. Let's go to the other side. Ready? So you have which leg? The left leg forward, your right was moving back, right? So now find the leg that's your stable leg. Here we go. Send it back. So it's going to be our left leg. We started with the left in the front, right was moving. Now the right is in the front, the left is moving. Ready? Bring it in. Find your single leg. Hold. Five little lifts. One, two, three, four, five, and hold. Bring it together. Just tap onto the floor and then send it back. Beautiful. Just hold your lunge. Bring it in. Single leg lift. It's one, two, three, four, five, and hold. Find the contraction in the quadricep on that leg that's working. Toes together, send it back. This is gonna be number three. This is the third lunge. Ready? Bring it in. Lift that left leg. One, two, three, four, hold it on the five. Hold it on the five. Toes touch, send it back. Perfect. Ready? One more, two more actually. Bring it together, send it long. Find the length first, find the alignment second, and let's lift. One, two, three, four, five, and hold. Touch, send it back. This is it, final single leg lifts. Ready? Bring it in. Lengthen the left leg minus my left. Longest legs in town. Longest leg. This is your final five of the single leg lifts. So make the leg long. It's a little uncomfortable on the standing leg. That's okay. Here we go. One, two, three, four. Hold it on the five. Go into your lunge. If you need your wall or your chair, that's fine. Otherwise, bring your hands into prayer. Up and down. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Hold it on the 10. Hinge into that front leg. Hinge into the front leg. Now, here's the beauty. Visualize that front foot. Your heel shoves into the floor. Really press your heels, kind of soften your toes. Come down just another inch. Think about the heel in the back foot. Bring that, just nothing moves except the heel kind of comes in a little closer and towards your butt. Hinge a little bit more, yep. Press the heels of your hands together really, really hard. Feel how that changes. 10 little lifts. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Hold it on the 10. Hold it on the 10. Squeeze your hands. Press the front heel into the floor. Soften through the toes. Take your hands down to the floor. Last long arm plank of the day. Just hold the plank. We're going to go into parallel arms and round it out with abs. Inhale. Exhale. Pike downward dog. Jump or walk in. Get into your wall. Bring your feet either when in parallel, your feet can be totally, totally tight together. Your knees super, super tight together. Everything super tight. Or you can have a small little distance between your feet. Now, parallels is exactly like it sounds, right? Instead of your feet being into cute athletic V, it's literally parallel to each other. So don't let yourself go into that athletic V. Bring the toes forward. So either a little bit of a distance between your feet, maybe like a fist, or everything super tight. Now the heels come up super high. I used Sydney's shoe that happens to be here as an example, but actually I wasn't a fan of the height of the heel. I'll show you. See, this is what she has. That's not high enough, friends. It has to be a little higher like that. So make sure that you're not using that heel. You're going a little higher than that. So let's do it. Same thing. Down. Check in. Is your heel high enough? Are you dropping your hips a little bit below that comfort zone? Let's just go for about another 30 seconds with Katy Perry. She's here with me, and here we go. Here for three, hold here for two. This is your final hold. So really push through here. Squeeze the thighs together if they're squeezed. Lift the heel up and then just come down for my count of three. Yeah, maybe a little sexier there, girl. For two, She is literally wearing like belly flats. For two, for one, and release. Awesome work. Grab your weights if you choose to do them with for arm. If you don't want white weights, that's okay. We're gonna go a little shorter on the front of us, and so that we can get to triceps because we haven't hit the triceps yet. Here we go. Ready? I like this song. Grab those weights. Let's start. Rotate the hand, bicep curls. Position, but now we have the hinge. We're going to finish the song open shut, and then as soon as the song finishes, we're heading into triceps. Ready? Here we go. Let's finish it here.
When you call me, say you're even, I wish it wasn't so damn hard to leave you, but every touch is la la la, it's true la la la, oh, I should be running, oh, you keep me coming for me.
Hold it on the open, hold it on the open. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Soften the shoulders down away from your ears. Think about lengthening out through your neck. Bring your hands next to you. You still have that cute little hinge. Soften through your, perfect, soften through your knees, hinge just a little bit forward, pull the abdominal in so crazy tight you can't even stand it, and then send your hands back behind you. Your palms are facing each other. Your palms are facing each other, and it's tricep work. Remember that the arms stay super crazy, crazy long. All right, here we go.
Would you rescue me? Would you get on my back? Would you take my
lift. Call? Little lift, little lift, rescue lift. And then we're gonna go soft bend reach.
Would you rescue me when I'm by myself, when I need your love, if I need your help? Would you rescue me, would you rescue me?
Soft bend reach.
We don't talk much, not anymore. Broken bottles, slamming doors, but we still care about each other. Say we care about each other. I know life took us far away, and I still dream about the good old days when we took care of each other. We were living for each other.
Hold, hold that beautiful soft bend reach. This is really super fun. You're gonna take your body, lengthen it, lengthen your body, and then you're gonna take your hands bring them all the way up overhead. Your hands are still facing each other. So yeah, you're reaching towards the sky, soften your shoulder down away from your ears, and then rotate, this is weird, rotate your palm to face behind you. So it feels weird. Yeah, your hands are overhead, your hands are facing behind you. Soften the knee, pull the abdominal, and then bring your hands like you're taking a bow. Take your hands back behind you. Look at that. You're back into tricep, different angle. Longest arms. Here is the little beat. Let's do it. Just little lifts, lift, 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 lift. Soft bend reach. Soften the shoulders down away from your ears. Lengthen out your neck. Now, bring your hands next to your hips. Lengthen. Bring your hands up overhead. Now, rotate your hands to face the front of you. So it's facing front. It feels really natural, right? That's your natural sensation. Here we go. Final push. Now, in this position, when the hands go back, we don't soft bend reach. It's just, go ahead. Let's do it. Soften the knees. Bow forward. Now, it's a true bow with the hands like if you were in, a movie and on Broadway, you'd be holding your friend's hands to bow. Here comes your hands. They're facing the ceiling. No soft bend reach in this position, friends. Just lift. Ready? Let's lift to finish.
What you can't get back and you can't find in another. Man, time it ain't your lover. I don't care what you call me for. I'll be there in time you call. But you never call another. No need to call another.
Hold it here. Lengthen out through your head. Your neck, the top of your head goes towards the sky. Your arms go crazy long, and maybe they go up just a little bit higher. Hold for 3, for 2, for 1. Stack your spine. Go ahead, release your weights. Take one huge inhale, one final little round of abdominals, and we are done. Forward fold in your exhale. Beautiful. Just hang in a cup for a couple of breaths in your ragdoll. Take your hands to the floor. Send your feet back. It's just a transition. Send your feet back into a long arm plank. Don't get scared. It's just a quick hold. Inhale here. Tap your knees to the floor. And then grab your little pillow if you choose. We're doing low C curve. The little pillow is just to have a little bit of resistance between your thighs. You don't need it. You absolutely don't need it. So our feet are going to be hip distance width apart. If you choose to have the little pillow between your thighs just for a little resistance, feel free. You can have a bear. You can roll up a towel, whatever you want, or nothing at all. No problem. You're on your elbows like if you're at the beach with a pillow between your thighs. Who goes to the beach with a pillow between their thighs? Here we are. Open up that chest. Now, send your low back into the mat. So it kind of tucks your hips. And now move your elbows out of the way and softly grab behind your thighs. Or you can put your hands behind your neck, head, and shoulder, right? So the key to low C curve is that low back flat against the floor, the chin away from your chest. And then let's just curl it. It's 1, 2. Why not finish One Republic? Let's finish the song. Ready? It's just a little beat to keep us going.
Rescue me, would you get my back? Would you bring my car when it's about to crack? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me? When I'm by myself, when I need your love, I need your love. Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me?
take my call when I stop to crack? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me when I'm by myself? When I need your love, if I need your help, would you rescue me? Would you rescue me?
And release. Take your pillow from between your thighs. Send your legs long. Actually, you know, that's a good idea. Go ahead and keep your knees in. Let's just do a 2-minute stretch because we do have 9:30 yoga. So we gotta make sure that they can set up for that. Take your knees, drop them to one side, your hands to the other. If your legs are long, that's okay too. Otherwise, you can do a little back stretch. Bring the knees back to center, drop the knees to the other side. So ladies, I have no idea what got into my husband that he wanted to come in and take pictures of us. That was hilarious. Inhale. And if you have taken my class in the past, there's a Netflix series that I'm in actually that I created. What is it? Falling for Brian. No. What is it called? I can't remember. It's something about the falls. And the long story short, but now you guys have proof that he's still alive. Go ahead and lengthen out through your feet. Just take one 30-second breath, a huge inhale, a huge exhale, one final huge inhale, one final huge exhale. Move out of the way of my model. Take your time, friends. You're at home. Stay on the floor as much as you like. Do a couple little extra stretches. Log back in to do yoga. Have a great rest of your day. I am here Sunday at 9:30. And I think somebody else, I can't remember who's teaching yoga next, but it's at 9:30. Thank you. Love seeing you guys. This is really fun.
Thank you so much, Monica. It's a total hoot.
It is a total hoot.
You're awesome.
Have a great day.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Have a good day. Thank you, Monica.
You're welcome.
Oh. And I think you're